Well, parts 1 and 2 videos were up on my YouTube yesterday, September 17, 2021. And apparently YouTube doesn't offer the ability to add photo collages any longer. They're called cards in videos, so I was unable to edit the complete audio version for my YouTube with a decorative background instead of the band performance. However, that 4.3 Carson earthquake yesterday really threw me off, and we didn't even feel it here in northern San Diego. But earlier in the day, we were probably just under 10 miles northwest from the epicenter in Gardena. 3 days in the grave, we're in the studio, and I was recording and filming them on my two cell phones. So I'm thinking 3 days in the grave caused the earthquake. Man, this video really rocks after editing it on my special app. I really screwed up on part one, the video, trying some YouTube editing thing, so I had to resubmit it. And after my podcast, I'll have already the file converted into one MP3. And anybody can download it for free on my Spreaker account. So I'll work on getting all the photos on this Facebook status with the videos I have on my Facebook. But back in 1989, speaking of earthquakes, during the World Series Loma Prieta earthquake, that was San Francisco Giants versus the California Angels. They were called, I think they were called the Los Angeles Angels at the time, but originally the California Angels. And how ironic that an earthquake of this magnitude would be the World Series and plus two California teams. And it happened just before the game was to start. So it's like everything about this was like the most epic for live performance sports plus live on television. So it was pretty really ironic. So but back in 89, during the World Series Loma Prieta quake, then the January 1994 Northwood quake, I was living in the small town of Trona in the Mojave Desert. The Northwood one was actually on Martin Luther King Jr. Day about 4 a.m., and I was up getting ready for work. Yesterday's was on U.S. Constitution Day in Carson, California, and was described as a hard jolt, then shaking for at least 10 seconds. Both San Francisco and Los Angeles quakes were about 10 or 11 miles deep. So because of the desert, which was probably 150 miles away from Los Angeles, and actually probably about 200 miles away from the Loma Prieta quake, which was up near Sacramento or San Francisco. But that's the geography of where I live. So it's kind of like a triangle. Here I am east in the desert, and it's like a pyramid. You go a little bit north, east, northeast. And then from where I was at, the location in the Mojave Desert, you can go west, northwest, and get up to the San Francisco quake. But they both felt like the ground was like a skateboard speed wobble, if you know what those feel when you're going downhill and your skateboard starts wobbling. Then it felt like standing on a wobbling bowl of Jell-O. I've never felt that, but if I could imagine it, that's what it felt like. So I still haven't felt any hard jolts like everyone is saying about the Carson one yesterday. But two friends actually said the jolt was as bad as the 1971 Sylmar quake. I think that was like a a 6.6 quake. And yesterday's Carson quake, the last they recorded it, it was a 4. They said 4.3. So because of the depth of it, it's easily shaken. It's like if there's something 11 miles deep in the ocean, that means it's 11 miles underneath the ocean floor. So we hardly feel anything coming from those. But when you're on land and it's 10 or 11 miles deep, that's shallow. So I remember when feeling that one, the Los Angeles one, when I was about 7 years old and felt it in San Diego. But the 85-mile distance between the area in Los Angeles and San Diego, it made it like a tiny rolling sensation. So I have my YouTube links up for the two parts of the video edited, which is why it sounds so good, because I did it on my cell phone. You don't get good recordings on your cell phone, but with this editing tool app, it's pretty awesome. But select my link to see parts 1 and 2. And 3 Days in the Grave bandmates going forward are Robert Tyler, Gene Copley, and Greg Whitstock. Robert's lead vocals, guitar, Gene Copley is drums and vocals, and Greg Whitstock is bass and vocals. And one of the songs, I can't remember which one, but was extended for Imran Ahmed of Project X, which you've also heard plenty of on my podcast. And he collaborates with 3 Days in the Grave and so many more. But all of their tunes can be found on Spotify, iHeartRadio, YouTube, and on most streaming and podcast outlets. So let's go with yesterday's live performance. Actually, not a performance, but studio rehearsal with 3 Days in the Grave on the Lookout Guy podcast. And I'm Michael Tobin, your Lookout Guy.
All right, all right, all right. Yeah. We'll be right back.
song again.
Yes.
Thank you.
Bye. mind wanders just for a quick second.
Do you hear a whistling from one of those?
It's mine. I tried to turn it down, but okay. I was trying to figure out which one it was. It is that one. The bottom one is down the lower.
When your mind wanders,
I knew it was too hot. Yeah. And
I was sitting there
thinking, okay, that was check. I was thinking that was a nice amount of time for that. Just that extra little bit of time in there for
I'm
the,
trying to get the backing you up on the first part of all three of the things.
Yeah. No, I'm talking about the lead, man. The middle part. I was thinking to myself, I stopped to think that was perfect, but then I forgot the lyric for the song on the left.
Okay, so the break, that's how long we're going to do it?
Yeah.
For Imran to play something.
Yeah, just a little bit longer. Go through it two times. Yeah, so four times.
Before you go.
Yeah, before I go. Yeah, so that'll be long enough to...
We haven't practiced this a lot. I remember on Norm Can't Drive, you forgot to do the track at the gig.
But I'm going...
Usually,
in the video, it's really solid.
Yeah.
I'm all.
You never did it.
Crack.
Right? You got that hard snare. Crack! Bam! Chop!
He forgets. He's even forgotten. No.
Let's do that intro only.
Right okay, now. Do it.
Just so he can refresh himself.
Thank you. right.
All right, Dwayne McDangle.
The gift. Turn on the lights. You need some water? Yeah.
My fingers are getting hard for you.
All right, go ahead and put that on hold for a minute. I'm eating wig right now.
Are you doing Dancing on the Edge, the chorus or the verse?
Do me a favor, don't do the cymbals there. That's not.
Extra beat though, I made one mistake.
time on that.
This is Gene Copley, drummer for 3 Days in the Grave, and you're listening to the Lookout Guy, Mike.
He's going to
on the chorus.
On the edge of a losing game.
She
can try it, see what happens.
All right. So your little drum part comes in first.
You can do it lower volume, and I'll do the high part.
I'll creep around and do the...
Alright, yeah!
Alright, yes. That was 3 days in the grave. And that was performed in studio in Gardena, California, just about 3 miles away from that earthquake yesterday on the 17th of September. It was 4.3. Really rattled people's nerves. It was scary from what I hear. But anyways, this is has been in a long time making, but stay tuned for more of the Lookout Guy podcast, because I have a secret. Somebody who did a cover song of a extremely classic, extremely classic popular tune, and it's a secret. I don't even want to mention her name yet. But also somebody else who has been on the Lookout Guy from the world of indie artists and music and writers, Ricky Davis, with a brand new release, Angel on My Mind. And so stay tuned for that. I'll try to get it this weekend if all goes well. And now, finally, at the conclusion, this is where I get to tell you that you can receive prayer. It doesn't matter if you are backsliding, easy riding, in the clouds, up on the top of the mountain or down on the rough side of the mountain, doesn't matter. You can receive prayer 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And the last I heard, this prayer line from the Billy Graham Evangelistic Association has been in effect since March of 2020, the beginning of the germ thing going on right now. The last I checked, it was last March of 2021, about 6 months ago. Over 450,000 phone calls. Many people got prayed for. I even called it. And you definitely know that you're being listened to when two or more are gathered together in Jesus' name. As Jesus says, where two or more are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst. Imagine that. That's powerful. So call this number, 1-888-388-2683. That's 1-888-388-2683. And I want you to listen to this.
One of the phone calls that I got was from a gentleman who's in a nursing facility. He's worried about the coronavirus. He's wanting to go home and be with his family. When I asked him where he would go if he died today, would he go to heaven? He said, I don't know. And he said he wanted to know. And so I was able to go through the plan of salvation with him. Before I could even finish, he said, I want to pray that. I want to do that. And I said, I'm going to lead you through all of that. And so we went through it all, and he wrote down the references, and I led him in that prayer of salvation and told him to write down this date that he could be sure that he had asked Christ into his heart. It was terrific. He felt relieved. He said, nobody's ever told me the things you've told me today.
Call that number, 1-888-388-2683.